Hi everyone, Eloise here for Pretty Pink Posh, and today I'm going to go ahead and make a card using the Be Friends stamp set. For this stamp set, it is only available through qualifying purchases, so that means you have to spend a certain amount of money to receive this stamp set while supplies last, which is super fun. It's a great stamp set, so I encourage you guys to place an order and hopefully you can pick that up. So along with using the Be Friends stamp set today, I'm going to be doing the bubble watercolor technique. Now, I don't know if you guys have ever done this in primary school. I know I did a lot and it was one of my most favorite things to do. So basically, the bubble watercolor technique is what I'm calling it, but you just mix water, some dishwashing liquid, and also some paint. I'm actually going to be using watercolors today, but generally you will just mix those three things together, blow some bubbles using some straws, and then you go ahead and place your paper on top, and it creates a really fun bubble look. So I'm going to go ahead and start with a large bowl here. It's quite wide but not very deep, and I'm just going to go ahead and probably fill it around a third of the way with just some water. I'm just using a bowl of water here since it was easier, but you can use whatever water, it doesn't matter. And then I'm going to go ahead and use my dishwashing liquid, pour some inside, and then mix it up with my spoon. And so now that that's all done, you're going to get a lot of bubbles since I use quite a lot of dishwashing liquid, and that's what you want. So now I'm going to go ahead and use my straw and blow some bubbles. So now that the bubbles have been blown, I'm going to go ahead and take my watercolors and drop some color on there, and you can see that it doesn't really work well if your watercolor is too thick, because I found mine was too thick and heavy and it popped the bubbles, which is not what you want. But you can see the second time I went in here and tried to do the technique, it was a lot more liquidy, so you got a better effect. So now that I've done that a couple times with that greeny blue color, you can see here it's the makings of the bubble watercolor background, but I didn't really like how light it was. I wanted it to be a lot darker, so I pulled in a darker color of blue, and again you can see here it was a bit thick at the start. I probably should have shook these containers up a little bit and got rid of the thickness, but I did forget. So something a lot more liquidy, maybe like distress ink reinkers would work a lot better for this, but I wanted the vibrancy of the Dr. PH Martin watercolors, so that's why I went with those. But distress ink reinkers would probably work much better. So I just went ahead and repeated the same steps a couple times over, and then used my heat tool to dry it, and this is the results you get. Looks super fun, super different. I really love it. So now that I've gone ahead and finished my background, I can start with my coloring of my images. So I'm going to go ahead and use my Copics today, just because I find them a lot quicker and easier than any other coloring mediums I own. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp them down with some Memento Tuxedo Black ink onto some Nina Soloite cardstock, and then I'm going to pull out my Copic markers. So I really love coloring images like this, like bees and snowmen and stuff like that, because you don't have to use a lot of colors, so which means it's going to take you a lot less time to color. So this is super quick and easy Copic coloring today. You don't even need to color this many for this card. I just did so I can have a few extras. So I'm going to go ahead and start off with some blues, and I did forget to show the caps at the start of the colouring, but I've put the names of the colours I'm using in the left hand corner. So I've just gone ahead and starting off with B quadruple zero, and I'm just starting off on the edges and sort of fanning that out, or flicking it out I should say, and then I'm going in with B triple zero and I'm blending that out a little bit more and just making that color go further. Now I'm going to go ahead and just fade that blue into white with my zero marker. So I'm just going in circular motions just on the top of that blue color there to fade that out. Now it's time to move on to the yellows. So I'm going to be coloring from darkest to lightest, and so I'm starting with my darkest color on the bottom of the bees here. So I'm just going ahead and putting some color on the bottom and then flicking it upwards. So I'm using Y19 for that, and then I'm going to come in with Y15 and I'm going to blend that out. So Again, I'm just going over the top of that 119 and sort of fanning that brush upwards and blending that together. Then I'm going to go ahead and blend the entire yellows together with the Y13. And I think this trio of yellows here works really well for bees. You sort of got that more orangey yellow at the bottom and then it fades up to a real bright yellow at the top. It's really fun. Now I'm going to go ahead and move on to the black part of the bees. And when you want black colours to appear more black but you don't want to use a black marker, I really like to use the cool grey markers. So I started off with the C9 and just coloured at the bottom the same as I did at the yellow. And then I went in with C7 and I just blended that out a little bit more, the same with the yellow. And now I'm ending with C5 and I'm just blending all of those colours together. And when I use the cool greys, I like to use either all even numbers or all odd numbers. I just find that works a little bit better than having, you know, say C6, C7, and C8. I like to use C5, C7, and C9. I find it works a lot better that way. Now I'm going to go ahead and just use the 119 for the little pointy bits on the bottom of the bees. Now that I have finished all of my colouring, I'm going to go ahead and use the coordinating dies to cut all of these images out. The great thing about the coordinating die set for this stamp set is you can cut out the little dashed trails here, which is super, super fun. I love seeing them cut out. They just are really nice to be able to either pop up with dimension or to stick them down flat on your card. It's really fun. So now that I've die cut out all of my images, I'm just going to go ahead and use the little angular die here from the Stitch Notes die set and just put that down on the bottom of my panel here, the watercolor panel, and then run that through my Big Shot machine. So now I have a fun angle die cut off my card. So for the sentiment, I'm using the Thinking of You stamp sentiment that comes in the same Be Friends stamp set, and I'm just stamping that down directly onto my panel here with some VersaFine Onyx Black ink. So now that I've gone ahead and stamped that down, I can adhere my panel onto my card base. So I'm just using some 3M foam adhesive for that, just adding quite a few strips on the back, adhered that down to a Nina Solo White card base, and now I can go ahead and add on my bees. So I'm using dimensional adhesive for the bees themselves, and then I've just gone ahead and used some Tombow Mono Multi Glue to adhere down the trails, and I just did that since I wanted them to be flat to the card. I just thought it looked a little bit better. So now that I've adhered everything down, my card scene is basically complete. I'm just adding some finishing touches now. So I've gone ahead and used my clear Wink of Stella brush pen to go over the wings and the little yellow parts of the bees' bodies just to give them some sparkle and shine. And then I'm going to go ahead and add some sequins. So I'm just using some sparkling clear sequins today since I really want those bees to be the standout and on top of that background. And so I felt like if I used a sort of a darker color of sequin, it would take away from that. So I thought that using the sparkling clear would just work the best in this case. So I've just adhered a trio of three at the bottom and the couple of other sparkling clear sequins at the top, and I'm just using some multi-medium glue to adhere those down. Anyway, now that those are adhered, my card is complete. So I hope you enjoyed seeing the bubble watercolor technique today and give it a try yourselves, as well as having a look at the Be Friends stamp set. Again, that stamp set is available with qualifying purchases, so check out the website for more information on that. And yeah, so if you haven't subscribed to the channel already, hit subscribe below. And thank you so much for watching, and we'll catch you next time.